Good evening, YouTube. Welcome to The Truth According to Lily. I am your host, Lily, and as you can see, it is gone.
And I feel wonderful.
I feel good. I knew that I would. The camera wasn't angled right. So yes, I am back, baby. After 8 months of growing out my fucking hair, it's back. And I love it. I hated growing out my hair every single fucking second of it. I don't know why I ever thought it was a good idea. I am just so happy and thrilled and just, I feel pretty again. I feel so good about myself. I feel confident and I don't have to wear a hat all the fucking time now. I had my mom cut off my hair last night. I was just like, I can't do this anymore. I hate my hair. I hate everything about the process of having long hair. I don't know how some girls have hair, long hair 24/7. You guys are the real heroes. I took the easy way out because I couldn't do it. I am a low maintenance kind of gal, and this is so, oh, my hair's so soft. God, I love touching my head and barely feeling anything. I love going like this and not getting poked in the eye. I love taking off my glasses and hair not being ripped out of my head, because that's a thing, guys. That's a thing. Took my short hair for granted. But I feel beautiful. Feel beautiful. You know, it's also a beautiful thing, sometimes, is story time with Lily. Actually, it's not usually a beautiful time. That's usually just me screaming into a camera. In the month of March, I gave my 2 weeks at the job I've had for 7.5 years. I then went into clothing retail, which I hated, and I was there for 3 days. And I was so utterly miserable. I hated the fact that my moral compass was being pointed in a direction that I didn't care for, and it was awful. And I took the easy way out and called my former district manager and said, hey, this is the situation. I'm miserable. I jumped the gun. I'm sorry. Will you take me back but put me in a different location? Because I can't go back to working with someone who was very difficult to work with. And she said yes. So I'm back to my old job, but in a new location, and I'm very happy. Like, I have not gone to work once this past week and a half. Unhappy. It's a long commute. Well, it's like 35, 40 minutes tops, but I'm happy. I'm very, very happy. Like, I have not been this happy going to work in years. I don't dread it. I'm not miserable when I'm there. I have not lost my temper once. Knock on wood. I really like my new manager. I like the whole management team. Everyone's very nice and welcoming, and it's making me really wish I had transferred to this store sooner. It's not like a dream come true or anything like that, because I still wish I was doing something else. But you know what? I really realized I'm happier, but this is still just a means to an end to me. This is a job that is literally going to pay for me to buy more Star Trek books so that I can review them and talk about them and be nerdy. This is a means to an end to me in that regard. That's what it is to me. It's going to fund me buying books and obviously paying my bills and doing other things, obviously, that are adult related. But my end game is that it's going to fund this YouTube channel so that I can keep buying Star Trek books, talk about them, review them, nerd out with you guys. I was so incredibly humbled when Dayton Ward saw my review of his book. I was so humbled by that. I was shocked. I was aghast. I was so appreciative. It meant so much to me. You have no idea that this guy knows who I am and thought I was funny. Like, that just made me so happy. You know, my mom was super proud of me and made me call my dad and then tell my dad in person. It was like my mom wanted me to tell my dad about this, which I thought was really sweet. And, like, my dad likes Star Trek, but he's not, like, a fan. And I've kind of forced my mom to watch a lot of Star Trek stuff, even though, you know, she likes it. I don't know if she's necessarily a big fan of it or anything like that. I was just so happy. It just made me so happy. I don't care if the guy never talks to me again. I don't care if he forgets about me. I don't care. Like, this guy knows who I am and thought I was funny. A Star Trek nerd thought I was funny. A best-selling New York Times author thought I was funny. Like, I'm still smiling about it. And I Instagrammed it, and I Facebooked it, and I was just like, oh my god, this is so amazing! This is happening to me! And And then David Mack asked me to review his book, his Star Trek book. And then another author of, who's like a co-collaborator with Dayton Ward, asked me to read his Vanguard Star Trek book series. And the first book, Harbinger, is coming in like a few days, and I can't wait to read it. Maybe this will be the Lily Talks About Star Trek channel, because it's working out for me in that regard a little bit. Unless I totally put my foot in my mouth, say the wrong thing, give the wrong book a bad review, and everyone hates me. I've already kind of ostracized myself from the Star Trek community by not liking the J.J. Abrams movies. I don't hate them. They're good action movies. They're not good Star Trek movies. That is what I was trying to explain in that video. Even though, you know, the reaction hasn't been that negative, but there have been a few people who private messaged me who were not pleased. Whatever. I stand by my statements. I don't think I'm wrong, and plenty of people don't think I'm wrong either if they liked it. That's the thing. I'm not necessarily like a Star Trek purist. Unless it's something that really just doesn't need to be there. Or didn't need to be changed. Like, I still hate Kelvin Kirk. I still hate him. You're not gonna get me to like him. It's not gonna be a thing. He's a dick, and he didn't work to get what he got. He got lucky. But yeah, just going back. So that's what's been happening in my life. Quit my job. Got a new job. Hated it. Quit that job. Got my old job back at a new location. I'm very happy. It's the happiest I've been going to work in years. Again, I really like the person who's my GM and who I'm working under. She's great. She's awesome. She's a fantastic leader. I have a lot of really positive things to say about her. We get along really well. The staff is really hardworking. Like, they're very productive. Like, the cafe is a slower cafe than the one I came from. The one that I came from is busy all the fucking time. This one definitely has its more slower periods than it has busy periods. But these people are still really productive. Like, you still get so much done. I feel like I'm behind a little bit, even though I've been there longer than most of them, or been in the company longer than most of them. And I'm really proud of the content that I've been posting on YouTube lately. I know it's all Star Trek related, pretty much, but I don't really care. It's what I love. I'm still gonna keep posting regular movie reviews, nerding out that Dayton Ward tweeted me more than once, and watch my video. And that David Mack wants me to review a book of his. Like, what? That doesn't... what alternate reality did I fall into? I don't know what reality I fell into, but I really like it. I really like it. It's nice. I'm not someone who's always sought approval from people or validation. I like being appreciated for the hard work that I do. And it was really nice that someone noticed it, you know? It's not even the best review I've ever done, in my opinion. But somebody thought I was funny. The person I was talking about thought I was funny. And that's just nice to hear. It's just so nice to hear. And again, I'm so humbled by it. Because I think I'm funny sometimes, but sometimes other people don't necessarily get my humor or don't know when I'm kidding. Or think I'm being really serious when I'm not. Life is far too short to take it that seriously. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine all night long. Life is a highway, I'm gonna ride it all night long. Those songs sound exactly the same. They're pretty much the same song. I've also been watching The Frankenstein Chronicles. I'm almost done with season 2. It's on Netflix, so you should definitely go and watch it. If you like Penny Dreadful, you will definitely like the show. It's kind of replaced Penny Dreadful for me. Like, it's not better than Penny Dreadful, but it's kind of taken its place because there's no more Penny Dreadful. And since I've fallen in love with a new TV show, there probably won't be any more Frankenstein Chronicles. So I am planning on doing a review of that, and I'm really excited. I haven't been writing as much lately. I think the well kind of dried up a little bit, which kind of sucks. I hate when the well dries up. Like, I finished my first novel like 3 years ago. The well dried up for 3 years. It opened up again a few months ago, and I used it all up. So now I have to wait another 3 years before the well gets full again. Which is fine, I guess. God, I just love my hair. Like, it's so fucking cute. Why did I grow it out? I don't understand what possessed me to grow it out. Oh, I was feeling unfeminine and insecure. But you know what? I just had to realize that I'm perfectly feminine with short hair. I think I'm very feminine with short hair. I had to learn that again. I'm just not a long hair person. I know my hair wasn't that long, but it was long enough to where I felt hideous. Hideous. Hideous every day. Well, that's all I got. some life updates, stuff that I'm planning on doing. And, yeah, I'm very happy. I didn't scream once in this video. Yay! That's a good sign. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. May the force be with you and stay tuned. You know how it goes.